So far, we got wires everywhere, but we're not done yet.
Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Audrey and I'm a special needs mom to Autumn, who has Down syndrome and autism. And I'm also a fit mom. So if you're into that sort of thing, make sure you hit that subscribe button. So today I'm going to share with you the sleep study. And I'll be honest with you, I have not been looking forward to this. I have been dreading it. So stay tuned. So I'm really, really not looking forward to Autumn's sleep study. And it is tomorrow, and I'm preparing myself mentally for it because she did really good the first time, but she was also a lot younger and she was a lot less stubborn about certain things. So I'm kind of like doing these like checklists through my head, like, okay, where am I gonna park and how am I gonna diffuse her if she gets really upset and what am I gonna bring? And I'm gonna bring her iPad, her pillow, and her blanket so that she's more comfortable. We're also gonna get her ready for bed, like she's going to bed. So we're gonna give her a bath, I'm gonna dry her hair and have all of her pajama stuff on, but then have her put shoes on. I think it's really normal for parents of kids with special needs that have to go to a lot of hospitals or specialists or different places, that's like the one thing that's very stressful sometimes, is literally just trying to find the parking situation, trying to pay the parking, trying to check in. And ever since we've had COVID, check-in is a lot different. Like sometimes they have to take your temperature. Sometimes they have to put a sticker on you. Sometimes they have to sign you in and do all these different things. And if you have a child with special needs, that can be really difficult. Autumn does not like any stickers on her. She doesn't like any bracelets on her. Any of that stuff will cause her extreme stress. It'll even cause a meltdown sometimes, which you guys have probably seen in my previous video. When we went apple picking last year, not this year, but last year, they required a wristband and Autumn would not wear it. And whenever they require a sticker for check-in that you've been checked in, I always have to put it on her back secretly, because if she knows that I put it on her back, she'll be like, get that off of me. Anyways, I hope it goes smoothly. Let's pray it goes smoothly. Let's hope she keeps everything on. Also, more importantly, let's hope that the results are still the same from last time, because I really hope her sleep apnea hasn't gotten worse, because if it has gotten worse, I don't know what they're gonna do, if they're gonna have her use a sleep apnea machine at night, which is gonna be really hard to keep on her. I don't know, we're gonna see. So hopefully it goes smoothly. Can you give him a hug? You're gonna be a good girl tonight, promise?
Yes, Mom.
Yes? Yes.
Say yes, Dad. Yes, Bowinkle.
No, I have everything packed. Hopefully I didn't forget anything. I packed Autumn's blanket and her pillow and her cup and like all the like toiletry items we need. I'm going to stick these masks in here. I also brought her pillowcase because I don't know how she's going to be about not having her pillowcase. And I have two waters, and I also brought her Crystal Light stuff that she likes because she's very particular about that. I have all my chargers. Let me make sure I had all my chargers. And I have her iPad, which is the most important thing because she will not sleep without having her iPad before bed. Hopefully we're not forgetting anything.
Good. Are you ready to go? Let me see your shirt. What does it say? It says, I got this. Do you got this?
Okay.
You're going to do good?
Good.
Okay, and they're going to put wires on you and you're going to be a good girl. Yes?
Okay. All this stuff. I got my backpack. I got this bag. And I got the iPad. Hopefully I'm not forgetting anything. So if I am, it's too late now.
Well, we're here. Now I gotta figure out where we park, Autumn. I have no idea, but we're gonna find out. I'm gonna turn it in here.
Looks like it's valet parking, but like I'm not 100% sure.
Oh, I guess the valet parking is $8. So we're gonna find out.
What's up, girlfriend? You gonna be a girl, yes?
Yes.
Why are you freaking out? There's nothing to freak out about. Let's sit over here. Come sit down. Something to be nervous about, girl. Thank you for being a good listener. If you want to stand, you can stand. Or you can sit on the table. You're silly. Autumn, do you want your iPad while we wait? Yes or no? Okay. Let me see if I can get the internet set up. We're in another waiting room. You're being such a good girl, and I'm proud of you. Yeah. Hold up.
Yeah.
Now we're waiting to go in the room, and you're being such a good girl. High five, Autumn.
Yeah.
Hold up. You are being such a good girl. I'm so proud of you. There's a bear in the back. The bear has a mask on, you guys. Look at the bear. Also, they have a charging station, which I think is so cool. Going up?
Going down.
Awesome. Oh, Woody and Buzz on the wall, Adam. Look. We love Toy Story. Oh, okay. So that'll be awesome.
Okay, so you can just go ahead and set your stuff down.
Okay,
and
take off your boots and you can have your iPad. Here, take off your boots. We have all this room for both of me and you, girl. We'll get comfortable and get your stuff out. Let me get your blanket and your pillowcase so you can be more comfortable. Does that sound good? Okay. So far, Autumn's happy because she's got her iPad, huh, Autumn? What do you think of our room? I brought your own pillowcase. I brought your blankets. Does it look good?
Good.
So far, so good. She's not freaking out or anything, but they haven't started putting the wires on yet. I just love how the room has Toy Story. So I'm guessing these are all some of the wires that they're going to be connecting to her. You guys, hospital beds. This looks very, very uncomfortable. I don't think I'm going to get any sleep, but that's okay. Autumn's bed looks much more comfortable than my bed. She gets an actual hospital bed. Autumn. Hey? You get a hospital bed that looks nice. Mine looks like doo-doo. So far we got wires everywhere, but we're not done yet. We gotta do two here and one here. Autumn. But Autumn is doing really good. And I'm proud of you. Good job. Can you say good?
Good.
You're doing awesome. I know, she did awesome. Give me a high five.
You did so awesome. Yeah. All those wires.
I don't know if I could sleep with all those wires on.
I know. It's so hard to sleep.
I know. It's so much stuff, Anna. No more wires. You did so awesome. Now I gotta go take a bath and get all that sticky stuff out of your hair. When we get home. Sound good? Mm-hmm. Yeah. But you did so awesome. So proud of you. And you slept so good. Mommy didn't sleep at all.
You pushed the button like a big girl.
All right, we're going up. We're gonna push number one, he said. Number one. Woohoo! You did so awesome! I'm so glad it's over. We're all done. Are you happy we're all done? Do you need to go potty? Do you need to go potty E? Now we gotta wait for the car. Are you cold? Are you ready for a bath? Yeah? I'm excited that I valeted. It's so much easier this way. It's so cool over here. You did so awesome. I'm so proud of you, girlfriend. I thought it was going to be $8, but it was only $2. Woo! Even better. Look at all the lights on the ground. Isn't that cool? It's pretty, huh? It's like rainbow color.
So when we first got to Chalk Children's Hospital in Orange, Autumn seemed pretty calm. We checked in at the counter, which I showed you guys, and then we had to kind of wait in the lobby for like the insurance person to talk to us so that we could get checked in with our insurance information and all that kind of stuff. And luckily it was all done electronically, so I didn't have to like fill anything out. I just had to sign some waivers and things like that. When we did sit in the lobby to wait for the insurance person, Autumn was starting to have anxiety. She didn't want to sit down, and I was getting a little nervous, like, okay, maybe she's starting to remember what we did last time. And so I was trying to not bug her too much, because I think the more that I bug her sometimes, the more anxiety she will get. So I was trying to leave her alone, let her sit down on her own, and kind of let her acclimate to the area. Finally, the person came back that was going to do the study, like the technician, and he walked us to the room. And I was like, okay, I was starting to have anxiety, but once we got to the room, I felt a lot better. And I was like, okay, it's going to be okay. And I'm like trying to talk myself through it, like, okay, it's fine. Autumn's calm. Everything's fine. Everything's fine. I was really happy because they did have like Toy Story decorations on the walls, and Autumn loves Toy Story. So I was like, hopefully that's soothing for her. So we got situated in the room, and I got out her blanket. I got out her pillowcase and put it on the pillow to make her more comfortable. I set up my own stuff, and then the technician came in. The part where they did put the wires on Autumn, I did do in a time lapse because I wasn't sure how she was gonna do. And if you guys watch closely, towards the end is when it got really, really bad. And I was starting to freak out and starting to think, we're not gonna be able to get this done today. She was trying to rip the wires off her face. She was ripping the wire off her forehead. So she had three on her face. She had like one here, and one here. And she ripped them completely off. She was screaming. She was trying to rip all the ones off the back of her head. You might be able to see that in the video, but it is in time lapse, so it's kind of hard to see. So I was just holding her arms down and trying to calm her down. I was trying to sing to her. I was just trying to do whatever I could to try to get her distracted. And eventually she actually was like falling asleep. She was really, really tired, and it was way past her bedtime. So I was rubbing her arm, I was kind of rubbing her back, and I finally got her to calm down to where she kind of fell asleep and was like in early stages of sleep. At this point, I wasn't sure if the technician was gonna like send us home or what we're gonna do. We're just gonna stay the night, but she's not gonna be hooked up to everything because it was all ripped off, or most of it was ripped off. And she didn't rip off the ones on the back of her head, so that was good. And she didn't rip off the ones that were like on her legs or on her chest, so that was good. So the technician came in once she had fallen asleep, and he's like, I'm gonna wait like another hour, and I'm gonna apply the rest of the wires to her face when she's sleeping. They also put like a cannula, I think that's what it's called, on her nose, and they waited until she fell asleep, which I did show you guys in the video when it was really dark in the room. That's when he was applying the rest of the stuff to her face once she had fallen into like a deep sleep. I wanna say at this point, it was probably like 10 o'clock and I was so tired, but I could not sleep for the life of me. I was just so worried about everything going smoothly and her not waking up and trying to rip things off and being traumatized. And I was just like, oh, I'm not gonna get any sleep. So that's what you guys saw in the video. I probably slept like an hour maybe. And I was wide awake like at 5 o'clock in the morning, and that's when I showed you guys the machine. Cause all the machine was making a lot of noise, and I thought it was gonna keep Autumn awake, but she actually stayed asleep. Once she fell asleep, everything went smoothly. But before she fell asleep, it was kind of like a disaster. And I was like, ah! The technician did come in a couple of times because she got super sweaty in the middle of the night. And he said, you know, we need to put a lighter blanket on her. And the only reason I brought her blanket was to make her more comfortable. But she didn't really need that warm of a blanket. So they gave her like a different blanket so she wouldn't be as hot. Because I think having all that stuff attached to you also makes you really, really hot. She's also like a stomach sleeper. So the way he had to put the wires and it was just kind of a mess. Also, like, I do wake up a lot in the night to pee, so like I had to wake up like probably 3 times, and I think it was also anxiety because I was anxious. But every single time I got up, I was afraid because I didn't want to open the door and then wake her up, so I was like stressing out about that. So when the technician kept coming back, that's when I'd go to the bathroom, because I was like, well, he's opening the door anyway. So I was like holding it in between, but I did not get any sleep. I was a total zombie in the morning. Otto was totally fine. All that sticky stuff was kind of a pain to get out, and I brought her home, and then Tom gave her a bath, and we got her cleaned up, and I dried her hair, and she ate breakfast, and she went to school, and she actually had a really good day at school, so that's good. I do have a follow-up with her pediatrician on October 17th, I believe, so she's going to go over the sleep study and a couple other tests that we've had to get done, so I will keep you guys posted on that. Overall, I would say it was kind of a nightmare. But it did get done. She did sleep. So it was successful. It's just, it was really stressful and I hated it. And Autumn really did, I think, hate it. And when she got up in the morning, I think she was glad it was done. Just like I was glad it was done. I was so glad it was over. What I will say is everybody at Chalk Hospital, Chalk Children's Hospital in Orange, is amazing. And we had a really, really good experience with all of the staff. And I really love that hospital. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you hit that like button, also subscribe, and hit that bell for notifications. Let me know in the comments if you have ever had any procedures done, and was it scary or did it go smoothly? Have you ever had a sleep study done? Let me know in the comments.